Hey everyone, Max from Effectful here. I'm very excited to be introducing our latest project, the Effect Playground, which is an interactive coding experience that we've built right into Effect's website. It's designed to allow you to explore and experiment with Effect's API, all without ever having to leave your browser. So let's take a look at some of its features. The Playground comes with a fully functioning Monaco editor that's running the latest version of TypeScript. So we can do things like hovering over variables to inspect their type. We also have full access to code completions and IntelliSense. And we also get diagnostics if there are any type errors within our program. The Playground also comes with a file tree, which allows us to inspect all of the files within our program and to potentially add new files or directories if our program grows beyond the scope of a single file. We can also edit the configuration files within our program, and the Playground will be dynamically updated to reflect this new configuration. The Playground also features an embedded terminal, which allows us to see the output of our program in real time. We can also edit our code, and the terminal will re-execute our program, allowing us to see the new output. But because this is a fully functioning terminal, we have the ability to escape out of watch mode, and then we can execute arbitrary commands to, for example, inspect the file system. Once you're finished writing your program, you may want to share your code with others. The Effect Playground provides a share button, which when clicked, will generate a unique URL for your playground, which can then be copied and shared with others to give them access to your code. But one of the killer features of Effect is just how easy it is to get started instrumenting and exporting telemetry data from your application. This is precisely why we decided to integrate the Effect Playground with the Effect Developer Tools. You may have noticed that within the Playground, we have this Trace Viewer tab next to the terminal. By importing the DevTools live layer and then providing it to our program, any spans that are registered within our program will be exported to the Effect Developer Tools. And just like that, if we click the Trace Viewer, we now have access to a waterfall diagram that describes the full execution trace of our program. And now for each of these spans, we can click on them and inspect any attributes that may have been registered with the span, as well as potentially any events that may have been registered for this span. So we can really get a lot of information about our program just by inspecting the execution trace. But what's even cooler is that if an error occurs in our program, for example, if we throw an error inside our generator function here, that error will be reflected in the trace that's generated, allowing us to visualize the trace of the error through our program as well. So thanks for watching. We're all really excited to see what you create with the Effect Playground, so make sure to share your Playground URLs with us, and happy coding!